Alright, so in this video we are going to build our first real UI, and we're actually going to build a really easy login screen. And we are going to build a login screen from, how is it called, from Hafsid Saki from Samarinda, East Borneo. He made these designs. If you want, give him a follow on Dribbble. And we are going to build this UI today. And the reason why we are going to build this one is because I think it looks really clean. And yeah, with this UI I can actually show you guys a little bit about how to build UIs with stack views. And yeah, it's going to be really, really cool. So, in the folder assets section 3, you will find a starter project and you will find a finished project. If you guys want to build this application with me or this view, open the starter project and let's get started. So let's go to Xcode. Okay, so welcome to Xcode. And the first thing we are gonna do, we're gonna give our view a background color. So let's check what the background color is from this one. And the color is 49, 49, 49. Oh, that's really easy. So I'm gonna click for background color, custom, and we're just gonna give this 49, 49, 49. So really nice gray color, looks really beautiful. Almost a little bit like how Xcode looks. Okay, so the first thing we need is a really big text. Hello, welcome back. Okay, so we can do this in two separate ways. Or we implement a navigation view, where the navigation view does this automatically. Or we do it ourselves with a label. And in this case, we are going to use a label so that you guys actually know how to build this yourself, right? Instead of using standard Xcode kind of things. Okay, so what was written there? Hello. Okay, so we're going to write hello dot welcome back. Okay, we're going to select the label and we're going to give this an alignment of left. And let's give this a color. We're going to give this a color white. And we go here to font. We're going to click on system, custom. And we're going to grab Futura as our favorite color, or as our font. We're going to give this a bold style. Let's make this bigger. I think this looks okay. And under here, lines, we're going to give this 2 lines. And the reason for this is when the label, because otherwise we can't do this, right? Okay. Let's make this a little bit smaller. So I'm going to make this smaller. Then we're going to make it higher. Like this. Oh. Almost. Make this a little bit higher. Okay, I'm gonna make this a little bit wider. Okay, so theoretically we should get this on the down one. So let's see if we can do this. Okay, perfect. Okay, so here we have our label. Let's put it on top here so that we have some space. And we're gonna put this one in a stack view. So let's give this a fixed height of 85. And after that, we're gonna click on embed and we're gonna click this and put this into a stack view. Okay, so as you can see now, it's all on the same line again. But we're gonna change that in a bit. Okay, so the next thing we're gonna need is another label. Gonna drag the label on here, and I saw that it had like a grayish color. So first we go to bold, then custom, then we're gonna check on Futura. I'm gonna make this smaller, so maybe 12. Perfect. And we're gonna give this a color of gray. Perfect. And we're gonna call this username, all capital letters. And as you can see, this is a little bit too dark, right? So let's go back, color, custom. And let's give this a color of 60, 60, and 60. Ooh, no, 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 no. Let's give this a color of 20, 20, and 20. Let's see what happens. And nothing happens. Why is this? Sometimes Xcode bugs out a little bit, so don't worry. Okay, now it works. Okay, so we made it a little bit black, and he made it like light grayish. So we're gonna make this, let's say 70, 70, and 70. It's also a nice gray. Let's close this again. Select them again because sometimes it bugs out a little bit. Okay, so instead of bold, we are going to use italic. So we're going to click here again. And oh, it doesn't support it. So let's say medium. I'm okay with that. Okay. So now we need a text field, right? So we're going to do text field. Drag it on here. And it has that a whole width. So we're going to give this the whole width of the viewport. Maybe like this. Then we're going to select that one as well. And then we're going to center this. Okay. With this one, we're going to do the same. We're gonna take the stack view. We're gonna put this in alignment with that one. Perfect. Okay, so we're gonna copy paste. Like this. And this one is gonna be password. Okay. So, as you saw in the designs, he doesn't have like a real text field, right? He has like this really small line under it. Xcode from itself doesn't support lines. So what we can do in that case, we can actually create a view, and we just kind of drag that one up. View. UI view, this one, gonna drag it on here, and we're gonna give this the same width as this one. What we can do now, we just can give it a height of 1. So, and this is how you create lines in a storyboard. So we can Ctrl C, Ctrl V it. We're gonna drag it on top here. Okay, and let's give this also a color, and it has a background color, and we're going to give it the same color, gray color, as we gave to our username. And we're actually going to give this a fixed height of 1. And the reason is, when we don't give this a fixed height, and we're going to put everything in stack views later, it's going to look really ugly. So for the second one, we're going to do the same, background color. It's going to be the gray color we use for the text. And we're also going to give this a fixed height. Okay. And what is next? The show button. We're not going to do this one. But we're going to use this one, the forget password button. So what we can do. Go back here. We do button. And we're gonna put this one. Over here. And we're gonna call this forgot your password. Question mark. And we're gonna give the text the same color as we gave our, let's make this a little bit lighter actually. Maybe we can make this 80, 80, and 80. I'm gonna make this smaller, so let's make this 10. Okay, and let's also change the font, right? Because we are using something else. So custom, Futura, let's make the text small again. So maybe 12, I'm happy with that. Okay, and last but not least, oh yeah, two more buttons, like this one, okay. Let's create another button. Let's drag it on here. I'm gonna make this one as big as this one. And let's make this one a little bit higher, right? So let's say 40. Yeah, I'm happy with 40. Okay. And now we need another button. And we're gonna call this one create account. And we're gonna give this one the same color as the forget your password. So what we can do, text color, that is this one. And we're gonna put it right there. Okay. So I suggest first we're gonna build this button. After that, we go to the next video, and in there we're gonna put everything in stack views, and we're gonna constrain everything, and so that after that we have like a great UI, right? Okay, so what we can do, we go to this one, and we're gonna select view controller. Okay, so as I stated in a previous video, when you work with view controllers, you always have like a controller here, right? And in that controller, we put all the code what we use for UI, or maybe when we want to give it functionality with functions or extensions. So we're gonna select this button. We're gonna control drag. So you hold control and you click on the button and drag. And in this case, we're gonna call this login button. Okay. So. First, let's see what the color from this button is. It looks really light. 87, 159, and 251. Okay, so I have to go back later because I'm sure I'm gonna forget that. Okay, so when we want to create like a cool UI or a lot of functional UIs, we actually build them using code. So what we can do, instead of like when you are here in Storyboard, you can actually also click a color here if you want. That's easy. But what you can also do, login button dot layer dot background color is equal to UI color red, green, and blue. And now I have to go back with my thermometer. So 87 159, so red is going to be 57 159, right? Or was it 87? Oh my god, my brain is 87. I'm so sorry. 87. And last but not least, it's gonna be 159 251, so 1 and 251. And we're gonna give this an alpha of 1. And it's always good practice to put the end of the scope there, so 255 255 and 255. And after that, as you can see, we get an error. And the error means, like all iOS related or UIKit related objects, like UI button, UI view, they don't understand UI color. So that's why we use CG color. So we do dot CG color, and then UI color is translated to CG color. Okay. As you can see, you don't see it here yet, but in the next video we're actually gonna see what it did. And in the next video we're also gonna add a small bluish shadow to it so that it looks extra great. So I hope you enjoyed this video. In the next video we are gonna finish the UI with stack views, and we're gonna finish the button, and after that we actually build our first beautiful UI. So, let's go to the next video and let's finish this project.